Darlington, where we will finally be doing the throwback race, which is race number 27 of the NR2003 PMU Cup Series. And right now we're doing pretty well, so let's keep it up from there. So let's get through the session as always, the qualifying session. So who qualified pole for today's race? And another pole for Sabre Fox. He will start on the pole alongside Casey Benz, Drew Walker, Angelina Patrick, Enos Kakia, Nicholas Wright, Dylan Hayden, Henry G. Brown, Leland Hill, and Tari Lowell, and the rest. So, we've got a few throwbacks to show you all. So right now, we will take a look at the throwbacks. Now, I'll be right back in a second. I need to do something real quick. Okay, so let's take a look at some throwback schemes. So here we go. So the first throwback scheme, for those that have not seen it yet, but some of you may have, because this had been entered for a few races beforehand. So Thaper Fox will be driving the Farmers 27 car, the throwback scheme. We have another throwback scheme, the Spotify scheme, that is Drew Walker in the 47 car, Angelina Patrick right behind Walker in that Autopods green car, I don't know, that Mountain Dew car, I think, that 36 car, Angelina Patrick. Then we take a look at another throwback scheme. That is a scheme that pretty much is the color of the Portuguese flag, or some sponsor for Portugal, TAP Portugal, and that will be driven by Henry J. Brown and Leland Hill. But this is the scheme that was entered before, but Leland Hill decided to call it a throwback. So, and there is Tari Lowell, slightly different scheme. It's similar to the scheme that he often used, the Haviline scheme, but this is slightly different. And that's the scheme he'll be driving for today's race at Darlington in that 52 car, Tari Lowell. And we've got Olivia Reynolds in that Exalta car, that flamey looking car, which gives me a reminisce of early 2000s graphics for computers and stuff like that. So that's the car that Olivia Reynolds will be driving today's race in that number 17 car. And there is a David Scott in the 53 car, in that black red line oil car. And this is another throwback that had been entered before in the season, but will return for obviously at the throwback for Darlington. So the red Dodge 9 car, driven by Roberto Crown Jr. And we go to a very interesting scheme that is driven by Camry Sr. That will be driven by Camry Sr. is the Bobby Labonte 88 scheme. Well, could have been more like a Labonte scheme. If you remove the 8 and replace it with a 1, that will be a true Labonte scheme. But instead of 18 is the 88 car, and Camry Sr. will be driving the AutoZone green Bobby Labonte car in today's race. Hold on for a second, and Solomon Sheridan. This is him in the 11 car, the nationwide blue car. That is, of course, another throwback scheme entered for the first time this season, or at least for this particular race. So another first time scheme. Don't know if this was ever entered early or at least another race where this scheme had been entered. I don't know. What am I thinking? Anyway, so moving on. Yeah, Solomon Sheridan. Keep an eye on out for Sheridan in that blue car. And where's another throwback? There it is. And there is David Dixon in the the orange Jeter DHL car in that number 45 car. Instead of racing yellow, he'll be racing gray with orange stripes. So keep an eye on David Dixon if you can. And there is the 19 car of James Jameson, that red, green and orange car, which is quite interesting to see. So James Jameson in the 19 car. And there is another throwback, and that is Leland Hill Jr. in that Interstate Batteries car. Quite electric that car is. And there is that looks like Bobby Allison. I think that's Bobby Allison scheme to me. And that will be driven by the number 12 car of Owen Scott. And quite magnificent looking gold and white car. And I think that's an Ally scheme. I think that's Ally the sponsor. I forgot. I don't know. And there's a red car, which will be entered for the first time as an unofficial throwback, thought of, but who knows. There is Sophia Petty, will be driving the number 5 car in that red car. And this will be known as the James, that's what I will call it. So, good luck for Sophia Petty, who will be driving the number 5 car. In the new number 5 car for today's race. So, the first time we'll be seeing a number 5 car in the season, after having driven the 96 car as a backup scheme whilst work was undergone to try and figure out what to do next. So, but now we finally got a 5 car scheme. So anyway, moving on. So the last 3 cars starting will be throwbacks, and the first one will be Bradley Ream in the 40 Coors Light car. Can't pronounce it well. And Camry Jr., I think that's another scheme that we've actually had seen in the series before. I think he'll be returning to this scheme for this race, at least the Budweiser scheme, that gray and white looking Budweiser scheme. And the last car to start will be Blake Parker, and he'll be starting in that O2 car. I think that's Koch. I think that's Koch, the sponsor that Blake Parker will be driving, that white and black and blue car. So Blake Parker will be driving that car for today's race. So, that's it. Let's move on to the race. Because we're about to get all revved up. And I'm thoroughly looking forward to see what this race will bring to us. So, let's get going. We should be looking good, so who knows? Let's get started. Whoops. All cars are revving up. He had to skip it, but anyway, let's hope that there's not going to be any problems coming out of the pit lane. It seems as though we're doing well. Let me get the volume up as fast as I can. So Sleeper Fox, another poll. Does he not choke this time? Is this not a fluke this time for Sleeper Fox? Would this poll that he got doesn't result in a fluke this time? Will he be able to hold on to it and try and fight for the lead for much of this race at least? We'll see what will happen in this race as we're about to go racing here at Darlington for the almighty throwback race. So let's see if Sabre Fox can hold on a little bit. Make sure those cars don't go wide too much, because anything can literally happen at this particular track. So right now things are looking good, and at the moment no caution as of yet, so it looks like Casey Pence will take the lead in the number 10 car, and that is a Guns N' Roses car, which is not a throwback scheme, but somehow is doing quite well. And Sleeper Fox down into second place. There is Angelia Patrick. She overtook Drew Walker, and now she's up into third. And now she's going to try and fight alongside the Sabre Fox car. Sabre Fox in the number 27 car. As Casey Benz will hop on into the lead. But anything can happen still though. Here comes Drew Walker on the 36 car. And trying to make a move on the 36 car. Did I show you the qualifiers, the standings? Did I show you pretty well? I think I did, but who knows? I don't know. Anyway, back to the front. As looks though that Drew Walker is getting surrounded now. Oh my goodness me, almost four wide. Almost four wide at one point. They're almost about to go four wide. It seems as though that Drew Walker is trying to... He's not falling back this time. Here comes Sleeper Fox. Back into the lead he goes. Sleeper Fox back into the lead he goes. And Angelina Patrick will try and overtake Casey Benz. But I think Drew Walker is gonna get involved in that battle as well. And there is Nicholas Wright as well. Nicholas Wright also trying to get his first win in his career if he can. But Casey Benz will continue to lead. And Sabre Fox looks like he's about to lose that position. Oh, dear me. On the outside, Angelia Patrick goes. What a weird way to overtake. And I think Drew Walker will try and do something on Sabre Fox. I think he's trying to replicate what his teammate Angelina Patrick had done. But I think Nicholas Rice is going to try and overtake him for fourth place at least. Oh, Drew Walker is responding. Quite interesting to see. We will keep a short eye on how these cars are behaving right now. Angelina Patrick up into second place as she chases down the 10 car of Casey Benz. And now look at all the cars all spread up. And there is Henry J. Brown, I think. Yeah, I don't think they're not teammates. They are literally two separate teams. Henry G. Brown driving the SLR car and Nicholas Wright driving for BPE. But there is Tari Lowell in that throwback scheme. And he's going to try and overtake. I think he's going to try and overtake Nicholas Wright. On the outside it goes. And Angelina Patrick getting close to the 10 car. And it looks like that I think Henry G. Brown's doing something. Oh, on the outside he goes. Henry G. Brown will overtake Drew Walker. He's overtaking Drew Walker now. Now Drew Walker getting into a sandwich of SLR Racing. SLR Racing sandwich between Tari Lowell and Henry G. Brown. SLR Racing hadn't had a good season. Not as good as last season before. Not as good as last season, although they had won a race with Henry J. Brown behind the wheel back at Canada. But that was pretty much it. That Tari Lowell hasn't been able to win a race just yet. So now here comes Drew Walker. What's going to Drew Walker do? He's going to try to use the inside line on Henry J. Brown. He's trying to use the inside line, but seems as though the outside line is getting better here at this track. I guess due to it being a short track. It might be it. It might be the reason why. But Drew Walker is under severe pressure right now. He's losing position now on the inside. But what can you get? This is the inside line at Darlington. So anything can literally happen. I'm not sure if I heard anything, but anyway. So Drew Walker is struggling. And I think, oh, here comes Angelina Patrick on the 10 car. And she's going to try and close in as much as she can possibly can. And whilst they are battling, let's take a look at the live standings right now. So far, no retirements as of yet. And we're coming up to lap 13. And let's take a look at another angle. Angelina Patrick is literally closing in on the 10 car. And Henry G. Brown is closing in on the 27 car. But it looks like the inside line is not in everyone's favor right now. Looks like the outside line is pretty much the line to use. Oh, looks like, oh my goodness me. Look at those two go. They're pushing Casey Benz onto the inside. Here comes the mighty Angie for the lead. And she crosses the line for the lead at lap 15. As she overtakes Casey Benz. And here comes Abra Fox. Let's see if he can try and if he can try and do the same as well. And it looks like Henry G. Brown is also catching as well. Abra Fox is getting really racy down there. Oh my goodness me. Looks like this is totally shaking up. Here comes Casey Benz. They're going side by side. Casey Benz is using the inside line to overtake Patrick. Now the inside line is OMG. Now the lines are changing for the better now. Oh my goodness me. Not for long. Angelina Patrick has gone back into the lead, but that would have been an almighty photo finish if this actually ever happened. If this was literally the last, that would have been an almighty photo finish. Anyway, continuing on, Henry G. Brown, Leland Hill, and Dylan Hayden are now trying to overtake Drew Walker. They're actually, Drew Walker is somehow trying to fight against them, but somehow not been able to. As Angelina Patrick will continue to lead. Fever Fox up into second place. And what's it going to be for Henry J. Brown, the Portuguese driver in that Portuguese livery car? And Henry J. Brown will try, and I think he's going to try to use the inside line. I think from drafting my help. Is it going to work? Hopefully, if he doesn't hold it too long, as he does. And it's going to be interesting. Here comes Sleeper Fox on the 36 car. The 36 car of Angelina Patrick. Oh, and he does get past. He does get past for the lead. Sleeper Fox back into lead. The box setter of Sleeper Fox. Henry G. Brown up into third. And looks like Keithy Benz is under severe pressure from four veterans behind him now. Are literally fighting himself with a rookie. Here comes Leland Hill for the lead. Not for the lead. For third place. Fourth place, I mean. I'm so messed up today. And it looks like that Angelina Patrick might try and make a move. Or is she actually under severe pressure? Maybe she can use Henry G. Brown for something. Maybe they're up to something. So, Patrick and Henry G. Brown might be the ones to watch. Hopefully we'll see what Sabre Fox is up to. It's somehow he's starting to increase the gap. Oh, look at Henry J. Brown. Oh my gosh, he's holding up Patrick. Oh my gosh, he's holding up Patrick at some point. No, they literally touched. Henry J. Brown literally clung onto the rear of the 36th car. Somehow that's putting him under severe pressure now. And look at that, Pizza Benz is literally fighting back. Literally fighting back. And, yep, Casey Benz is back, up in third place. Benz back into second place. I think Leland Hill is literally charging up to third place now. Oh, Eddie Flores Jr. stopped on the track. And there's no yellow flag, but yeah, he's blown up. Eddie Flores Jr. is out of the race after blowing up. Rest in peace, Eddie Flores Jr. He has blown up. Anyway, back up the front, back alive. And Leland Hill's having a bit of a struggle on the 10 car now. And that's the top 10. With Nicholas Wright hanging on to the top 10 spot. Is that a caution? It's a caution. It's a caution. But what happened? Let's see what happened right now. Oh my gosh, that looks bad. That looks pretty bad. And the James is wrecked. Damaged. OMG. Let's see what happened to Sophia Petty. Oh my. Oh my. One of the furbacks. Oh my goodness me. That looks like a double collision. I think that's all started from, I think it all started from Blake Parker. Blake Parker literally, I think, clanged onto the 40 car, and they both collided, and then taking two other cars with them, Patrick Thompson and Sophia Petty. We'll take a look at it at another angle. Well, on another shot. Whoops-a-daisy. Blake Parker literally got away with everything. Literally got away with everything. Let's take a look at one more shot and we'll do a couple of onboard cameras. Right. Couple of onboard cameras, I think. This time, yeah, we're on board Bradley Ryan. Onboard Sophia Petty. Now, pit stops. Saber Fox first. Oh, Leland Hill nearly got it. Or is he? He nearly got it. Anyway. Let's see if we can focus and get this race going. We're about to go racing in the next lap or so. The pace car pulls in. And we're about to go racing again at Darlington. Here we go at Darlington. Off we go again. At lap 30. So, what's going to happen next? Oh, Marcos Sanchez. Very lowly out of the pack right now. Let's see what happened. Did he make an early pit stop? Not early pit stop. Well, I guess he had problems during the pit stop. That's probably why. Oh my goodness me. Some cars are literally at the rear of... Oh, look, that looks pretty dangerous. That looks pretty dangerous. Look at those cars go. This is surely getting really scary right now. Casey Benz back into the lead. Leland Hill in second place. This is what I call an OMG moment. It looks like that Casey Bence is getting a bit better right now, as Camry Jr. has got a problem. Let's take a look. Let's see what happened to Camry Jr. He's got problems. I don't know if he came out for a penalty, I think. Yeah, I think he came for a penalty. We'll keep an eye on Junior. So anyway, back up the front, as looks like that Casey Bence will continue on from there. Leland Hill in second place still, but Henry J. Brown is trying to overtake Saber Fox. Now they're under a lot of pressure right now. And Lane Hill closing in on the 10 car. Closing in on the 10 car goes Leland Hill. And will he take the lead? Yes, he does. He will take the lead. Lane Hill in the lead. Oh, someone hit the wall. Some cars are hitting the wall. I think Henry J. Brown scraped some damage. We have to keep a close eye on it. It may not sustain much damage, but it's still pretty concerning to see and to watch. But right now, Lin Ho is still your race leader. He's now still your race leader. But we've got a lap car coming up. And that is Cameron Jr., who is seriously trying to get away. He seriously wanted to make up for lost time after a dreadful start of the race. Now, well, he's now a lap down, sadly, so can't say anything much. So, but right now, Casey Bence is trying to fight back on the 54 car. I think the 54 car could win another race at Darlington, his second consecutive win at Darlington, if he can pull it off. Some cars are hitting the wall at Darlington, which is very concerning to watch. If they hit the wall too much, they will lose control, and then this will all happen. And I don't know, but this is getting very concerning to watch. So right now, we see four cars battling for the lead now, with Leland Hill still up the front, and I think Saber Fox is going to try the outside line on the 10 car. Let's go on board Drew Walker, let's see. And here comes Drew Walker. Is he going to overtake Saber Fox? No, he does not. Bad luck on the inside line. Sometimes the outside line works, sometimes the inside line works, but either way, it may not work. So that is something to keep an eye out. It's very confusing, Darlington, with literally anyone can pass one line or the other. But we are still on green at the moment. We are coming up to, well, we're not halfway yet. And at the moment, I think Saber Fox is struggling to try and get around the 10 car. Will he try use the inside line? The outside line, I mean. And there goes Saber Fox, first, second place. But will Drew Walker try and do the same? And And the leading throwback scheme at the moment in this race is Drew Walker, and he's up into third place now, and he's seriously climbing up. But Leland Hill is still your leader. Let's take a look at the rear camera of Leland Hill and see. Oh my gosh, whoa, Leland Hill, what's going on? Leland Hill is up in the lead. What's going on, Leland Hill? Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. Leland Hill screwed up on the lead. Leland Hill screwed up on the lead. OMG. Wow. Saber Fox back in the lead of the result. Leland Hill literally screwed up. Look at it, he's got damage now as a result. Oh my gosh, Leland Hill screwed up in the lead. We gotta take a look at that replay. What an absolute screw up. He's certainly not gonna be happy. Seeing this. But look at it. Leland Hill screwed up at the Darlington wall. Look at this. And thanks a lot to that. Saber Fox is taking the lead again. What a funny race we're seeing right now. I need to watch this again. He's gonna blow his head off if he sees this. Onboard camera. Right now, Leland Hill is struggling to defend his lead as Drew Walker has overtaken him and is now in second place. He's still trying to defend position on Henry J. Brown. This is certainly not going to look good for Leland Hill now. He wants to at least move on to the next round of the chase, but it seems to me that it's pretty unlikely, I don't know, but he hadn't had a good race last race, so he seriously needs to up his game. Literally, he needs to up his game. But right now, Sleeper Fox is still your race leader, Drew Walker up into second place, and Leland Hill is trying to defend that position in a half-wrecked car. You know what, I think I wanna, before we take a look at the battle, let's take a look. There's a battle going along for the lead now, so before we watch, I want to take a look at the onboard camera of Saber Fox's view on Leland Hill, who literally screwed up on the wall, which was quite unbelievable as a veteran. So let's take a look here. Leno screws up. Anyway, here comes Drew Walker. Drew Walker is trying to fight. Drew Walker's trying to fight, trying to make a pass on for the lead. Here comes Drew Walker. What a pass on the 27 car. So let's see if Saber Fox will try and fight back. Saber Fox is closing in. He's trying to fight back, but we'll take a look at the pass quickly as we can, because we haven't seen it very clearly. So let's see. Saber Fox gets overtaken by the champion, Drew Walker. For the lead he goes. And the race will hopefully continue from there. And it looks like that Marco Sanchez has got a problem. He hadn't had a good restart, so it seems to me that his car is suddenly starting to give up. And I don't think it's likely he'll be able to rejoin. So, probably bad luck for Marco Sanchez. Leland Hill is now managed to get his car going despite the side damage. And he's trying to get back to the lead as much as he can. We've seen quite a few shenanigans at this track, which resulted in drivers literally taking themselves out onto the wall whilst leading, something like that. And this is no exception. This race is literally no exception. Here comes Saber Fox on the 47 car. He will try to lead back. They're going side by side. Oh, look, Drew Walker's responding. Drew Walker knows how to defend like a champion. And he is back up front, still in front. He was so close to losing that lead. But now looks as though Saber Fox is going to try again. And they're going side by side still. And Saber Fox is now trying to make it work, and he's making it work, and he's now up in front once again. And Drew Walker is also going to be threatened by the 54 car of a potential path. I think Drew Walker is responding to that moment. He'll try and use that bit of draft, although he's just trying to get away. He's going to try and use the unlikely outside line, well, the likely outside line that we're seeing in this race, where the outside line does at times get better than the inside line. And Drew Walker is trying to use that unusual pass on the 27 car. Let's see what he can do. And Drew Walker literally knows how to fight back as well, other champion. And Henry G. Brown manages to get past Leland Hill for third place. Leland Hill down into fourth. And looks like Casey Benz is going to get passed by the 48 car of Dylan Hayden. They're now nose-to-nose to each other, Saber Fox and Drew Walker. Here comes Drew Walker on the 27 car. They're literally fighting each other right now. This car, Saber Fox being an inferior car, but the 47 car certainly not as inferior as you think. Is in fact, he's a champion. Champions don't drive inferior cars. But you can see how inferior this car is. Look at Saber Fox. He's now working on on the outside line pretty well. Look at them going side by side, still side by side. But Saber Fox manages to get up front just for now. But is Drew Walker going to respond? Probably not quite. Maybe he'll try again on the next lap or so. But you can see how racy the 47 car is doing. And I think Henry G. Brown is going to join in for the battle for the lead. But I think he's going to do it with Drew Walker first. We've seen another round of pit stops. Potentially, I don't know. If a yellow flag comes in, then this will at least bring everyone at rest. This will put my mind at rest that hopefully we will see pit stops. At least a normal round of pit stops, not during cautions and all that. Unless we see another caution. Because it was so early when we had the caution, lap 25. So this could question of how they're going to last. But right now, looks like Drew Walker's under severe pressure with Henry G. Brown and Dylan Hayden. They're still behind Sleeper Fox, who is still leading at the moment. Cameron Jr. seemed unlikely to be lapped because his car is literally pacing pretty well. But I don't know if it's points for him to continue because he's been stuck there for quite some time. And here comes Leland Hill, who's trying to fight back on the damaged car. Here comes Drew Walker on the 27 car for Rising Sun Enterprises. Rising Sun Enterprises number 27 car versus CT Motorsports 47 car. Here comes Dylan Hayden on the Portuguese car of Henry J. Brown. Or SLR Racing, to say for the better. Right, let's take a look at the live standings for now. Looks like that Drew Walker is going to fight on the 27 car once again. And it seems pretty well. Here comes Drew Walker, and he will overtake the 27 car. But is Sabre Fox going to respond? They're going side by side still, but Sabre Fox, he's still on that line, so he might be able to try and fight back. Let's hope they don't clash. Pretty close, but is Drew Walker going to be able to keep it up? That's one question. Oh, inside line goes Sabre Fox. They switch places, and literally, now Sabre Fox is on the overtaken line on Drew Walker. But is Drew Walker going to respond? I don't think he's going to respond. I think he's going to have to try and do the same thing as what the 27 car has done. Sabre Fox. And Dylan Hayden joins in, and looks as though Sleeper Fox is going to be under pressure right now. Right now he's under pressure. He's under severe pressure right now. Wow. Interesting battle for the lead right now. And Drew Walker, he's up front at the moment, but Sleeper Fox on the other side might have a better line. Dylan Hayden up into second place. Off he goes, Dylan Hayden. And Liam Hill is now going to try passing the 27 car. I think the 27 car might have just had it. He was quite lucky to be able to lead for much of the race at the moment, but it looks as though that he's going to start losing pace now. He might fight back. That's my thought. But right now, Drew Walker is currently a race leader, but here comes Dylan Hayden in that Lowe's 48 Jimmy Johnson scheme car. And yes, he's also a contender. Is he a contender? Yes, I think he is still a contender. And Sabre Fox is going to lose another position, probably to Tari Lowell. And we see pit stops coming in. Let's see. Pit stops might be coming in the next few laps as Cameron Jr. makes his pit stop. This could probably shake up the whole field. Probably another couple of laps and then we will see. Yeah, we will see probably another round of pit stops. So let's see. That looks like that does not look like a normal pit stop to me. Cameron Jr. stopped. It looks unlikely. Yeah, you've got problems. Definitely got problems. Not so good news. Ooh. Not so good news for Cameron Jr. But look at that. I think Jack Halleck is pressurizing Lowell and Fox as well. Something to... Well, oh, look at them. Look at them go. Look at them go. And Cameron Jr. comes out. Don't know if it's a normal pit stop, but something to look at. He didn't change tires, so doesn't appear to me. I don't know. I'll need to take a look at Junior again. Let's see. Let's see how was his pit stop. Let's see. Oh, he did change tires and it was a very long pit stop. Whoa, some cars are hitting the wall and this time Flanders also got hit as well. Remember to watch out for the Darlington wall because you might get hit, literally get hit. I'm still going to question of how long they're going to last. Are they literally going to last through to the end of the race? That's one thing. But right now, Drew Walker is still leading at the moment. And Leland Hill is trying to catch up to Drew Walker right now. Dylan Hayden's still in third place. And Henry Giroud in fourth. Super Fox up into fifth. I think he's trying to fight back. Sixth place, Tari Lowell. Seventh, Jack Halleck. Eighth, Nicholas Wright. Ninth, Trey Meeks. And tenth, Angelina Patrick. Lap 74, less than 20 laps to go. On board, Dylan Hayden. Ooh, there's smoke. What happened? There's smoke. Let's take a look, but there is smoke. Whoa, Jameson got wrecked, but there's no caution. Sounds like an injustice to me. Whoa! Who is that? Is that Cameron Jr., the lap car? He's certainly trying to cause a stir. Oh no, the driver's now. What a stupid driver. What a stupid move that Cameron decided to do. On the 19 car. James Jameson got wrecked, but there's no caution. Anyways, back to the front. And Jameson enters the pits, I think, to retire from the race. Here comes Leland Hill on the 47 car. He's literally trying to bring his stricken car back in the lead. After that mishap of the wall earlier on in the race while he was leading, but now it looks as though that he's going to lose a bit more than what he thought. As Dylan Hayden will disrupt Leland Hill's chance of an overtake to try and overtake himself on the 54 car. This is certainly a three-way battle for the lead. Look at this. I think Dylan Hayden might try and lead a lap for the first time. And up in second place, the 48 goes. Still no yellow flag, no signs of a yellow flag. And I hope they don't collide. I hope they don't do a Jack Halleck Hayden collision whilst leading, because otherwise that would have been pain. Drew Walker is still up front, but what will Hayden do? Remember, I think Hayden won the race by beating Walker to the flag back in, that was his first ever race win, season 2 Indy. And he's fighting him again. Look at this, let's see if he can win a race at Darlington in that low scheme. It is technically a throwback. Well, if you're trying to throw back a Jimmy Johnson scheme. But Drew Walker is still leading right now. And Leland Hill is still standing. He's still a man standing right now. Is that a lap car? No, there's no lap cars. No lap cars at the moment. So we're all good. Homo camera. Saber Fox, we are now coming up to less than 10 laps. We're coming up to just over 10 laps to go. So right now, Hayden is still at bay in second place, just keeping an eye out of Drew Walker in case if anything happens. Ooh, Rei Ayanami has got damage. I don't think she has damage. She literally... Yeah, that's just a glitch. Don't you worry, it's just a glitch. Less than 10 laps to go. And Drew Walker is literally pacing up throughout the pack now. He's literally pacing right now. How fast is he right now? Yeah, he's got a hell of a faster car compared to everyone else. He's literally pacing. Obviously, there's no way of him making up for all the laps, but at the moment, he's literally pacing right now. and the laps are closing in. We might not see any more competition, or are we going to see more competition? Not real competition, but we're seeing close moments right now. Dylan Hayden is still looking behind Drew Walker. Is this going to be a pass for the 48 car? Or who knows? 47 versus 48. We've got 5 laps to go. 6 laps to go, coming up to 5 to go. Whoa! That's not Drew Walker, that's Cameron Jr. He's pacing! What the hell? Cameron Jr., one of the slowest cars in the field, is pacing. Wow, he's gonna ruin someone's day. I mean, he went for a pit stop, another pit stop. Well, an extra pit stop, and he's literally pacing right now. I think he's doing an Owen Scott moment right now. What an Owen Scott moment right now. I guess that's sort of messed up the battle a little bit, but is Hayden going to try again on the 47 car, or will he just give it to Drew Walker? We're coming up to 3 laps to go after this one. It's getting a bit closer now. Where is Harry G? Oh, is that damage? That's not damage. I think he just lost a few positions after that. Three laps to go still. We're halfway part of the track of the lap. Halfway lap at the moment. Here comes Hayden! Here comes Hayden! Hayden's gonna try and deny the win on the 47 car. Look at that! On that very outside, he will go up front to take the lead with only 2 laps to go. Right now, Hayden! What a move on Hayden right now. This is going to be a bit of a heartbreak for this throwback scheme of Drew Walker. Right now, Hayden is your new leader. And he only needs to do one more lap and he will win the race. But just out of a split second, I thought something was going to happen. There is going to be a battle for the lead. But Hayden is your race leader. One more lap to go here at Darlington. Hayden, is he going to do one more lap of leading? Or will Drew Walker streak back? I don't think Drew Walker is going to streak back. So that is it for Hayden. So that means he's going to win here at Darlington. On what was a last minute pass, an almost, 11th minute pass on Drew Walker. And now he's done it. He's proven it all. And he will take the checkered flag to win here at Darlington for the second time this season. Drew Walker, a very heartbreaking second. Leland Hill manages to nudge his stricken car for third place. Saber Falk, the pole sitter, wasn't able to at least finish in first, at least, but did quite a decent amount of laps of leading in fourth. 5th, Dramix. 6th, Tari Lowell. 7th, Jack Halleck. 8th, Nicholas Wright. 9th, Henry G. Brandon. 10th, Angelina Patrick. And yes, those damages are glitched, so please don't you worry. And the fastest lap time will go to Leland Hill. Leland Hill with a 29.424. And going down the points order, Riley Hill 11, Solomon Sheridan 12. Casey Penn 13, Enos Kakia 14, Blake Parker 15, Cameron Senior 16, Jonah Burr 17, Zach Campbell 18, Talon Soplu 19, Jace Chevalier 20th, Aditya Baggers 21st, David Dixon 22nd, Olivia Reynolds 23rd, Xander Howell 24th, Arati Alejo 25th, Nick Tanner 26th, Jimmy Irving 27th, and Roberto Crown Jr. 28th. And the rest. Well, interesting race. Well, that's it. So, let's move on to the all-important Charlotte race. So, thank you everyone for watching this race. We will see you at the next race at the Charlotte Coca-Cola race. Take care everyone. We will see you back on the track very, very, very soon.